Hello all, welcome to Pebbles. Myself Manmeet presenting Mom's Diary to you. So the chapter which we are going to open today from our Mom's Diary is that how to wake up early. In most of my videos, I have told you that you should get up early in the morning. Yes, that is very good for our health as well as it makes our day very productive. So we all know why we should get up early in the morning, because it's good for health, we get a lot of time for us and things like this. And especially moms, I would say that you should get up early because you will get some me time, which is very, very important, and you should be productive throughout the day. If you're somebody who wants to be productive and do a lot of work throughout the day, so you should get up early and you will feel that you are very active. Now, according to the study, a normal adult person requires 7 to 8 hours sleep in a day, and in a day, any point of time, you can take nearly 20 to 25 minutes power nap. Yes, that can be after lunch or in evening when you are really very tired after coming from office or something like that. So 20 to 25 minutes power nap you can take, that will help you a lot. And in this way, what happened that you should not touch your mobile phones, you should not see TV or something like this. You should just relax after, you should just close your eyes, lie down somewhere. If you're sitting on a chair, you don't have something to lie down, just close your eyes, fold your hands and relax and think of the things which you like, or you can have a sleep also, which will be very good for you. Okay, now let's start with the tricks which can help you to get up early. So my first tip for getting up early is that gift yourself a alarm clock. Yes, you should gift yourself an alarm clock. See, now you will say we all have alarms in our mobile phones. So why should we put an alarm in an alarm clock? It's very important, because alarm clock you will not put on your bed or in your near your pillow or something like that. You would place that alarm clock on some table, and I would suggest place it nearly in a distance where you should get up and walk in. You have to go to close that alarm. When you will do in this way now, so what will happen that when you will go to close that alarm, so you will be back to your consciousness, you will be back to your normal state, and you will know that yes, now I have to get up, now I have to go for work, now I have to do my work. So somehow your eyes will be open and you will be back to your conscious mind from your sleeping mode. So my first tip is that gift yourself an alarm clock. Now my second trick is that before going to bed, you should have a glass or 2 glasses of water. Water is very important before going to bed. Now, not for health or our appetite purpose, but the reason behind this for getting up early for drinking water is that when you drink water, you will get up at 4-4:30 in morning to go to washroom, and when you will get up nearly 5 o'clock also, if you get up, so somehow you will get to know that yes, now I am open, your eyes will be open, and somehow when you go to wash your hands, you can flash some water on your face, and then you will get to know yes, now I have to get up, and maybe you get down. So it is very important. Now third thing is that now prepare your priority list before. Now when you will prepare your priority list before, means suppose tomorrow you want to get up early, so today before going to bed, you can say your to-do list, which I told you before also, you prepare one priority list. Now in this priority list, just see what are your priorities. Maybe for a mother, her priorities will be her children, her husband, her home, and maybe I'm not sure, your health also. Yes, why I said maybe, because in all these responsibilities, we women just leave our health and our me time. So I would suggest you in your priority list do add upon your health and your me time. So for these 4 priorities also, you have to get up early. you think if you will not get up early, you will not be able to send your kids to school, and your kids will be 7 to 8 hours away from you. They will not meet you for 7 to 8 hours. So how will you feel? You will not feel good. You definitely want to meet them, and you want to give them something. You want to feed them. You want to give them tiffin so that they are not hungry throughout the day. They should eat something. So in your priority list, if your kids are there, so definitely you will get up early to give them food. Now, next is your husband. Same thing goes. Tiffin, breakfast, everything. You will get up early, but your home will also be there for cleaning and everything. But if your priority, your first priority will be your health and me time, then you had to get up early, because you can't think if your kids bus is coming at 7:30 and you will get up at 6:30, you can go for a walk. No, you will not be able to go for a walk, because you have to make tiffin, you have to make your kid ready for the school. So I would suggest in your priority list, you are keeping your health before, so you have to get up one and a half hour early to go for a walk, for some me time, for drinking some detox drink, everything like that. So your priority list should be ready. On that basis, definitely you will get up when you will know that yes, this is a priority, this is necessity I have to do. Now that can depend from a person to person. If you are not married, if you are unmarried, your health, your other work can be on your priority list. It depends upon person to person, so accordingly you can set that. Now, fourth thing. Yes, if you want to be productive, just tell yourself, sit for a while and just think, do I want to be productive? Do I want to be very much indeed for good deeds, indeed be a better person, or I am just for doing my households and everything like that? Don't you want to be productive? Don't you want to do something extra? If you have seen my last video, in that I have told you that how your hobby can be your interest, your hobby can be your work also. So if you want something like that, and that means that you want to be productive, so you have to get up early. See, if you want that, I should do something, I should be more productive, I should do many things, not just the regular things which we do in a day. So for that, you have to get up early. See, what happens, this happened with me also, that someday I think, okay, my work is less, it's just a bit work, I'll do this on this time, I'll do this on that time. And that day, definitely, if I miss my routine, that is getting up early and starting my work late, I end up with no work. Something don't get complete in my to-do list, and that is very, very, very bad. So I would just suggest you, if you want to be productive, you have to get up early and you will feel fresh. So my fifth point, or my fifth trick for getting up early, is that do your dinner by 8 p.m. and in small portion. Now when you complete your dinner by 8 p.m. so what happens, your digestive system is also good, and in morning, if you will not eat much in dinner, don't take like full meal or something like that. Take something light. If you eat 3 chapatis, try to eat 2 chapatis and have a glass full of water. So what will happen, that in morning when you will get up more early, you will feel bit of hunger also. So you will feel that no, I should get up. And when we, our tummy is fully full, so we sleep for a long time. So if your tummy will, I'm not saying that stay hungry, don't eat. You eat as much you want to eat, but not eat something heavy or something like that. Eat a small portion so that you should feel some bit of hunger in early morning, and you will get up, so that you will get up, you will brush your teeth, you will take a bath more early, and for your breakfast. So it's important if you will have this thing. And in this, one thing more will be beneficial, that you will not skip your breakfast, which is very important. So I hope these tricks will help you to start your day early. And if this thing, tricks helped you and you find it useful, do let me know below in the comment box, and do like, comment and share this video. And in all my videos I say, be positive and be happy, you will win the world. So always be positive in life, always say yes, I will get up and I will be, and always stay happy, because when you are in stress or you're in something, so you will not get a perfect sleep at night, and if you will not get perfect sleep at night, you will not be able to get up early. So it's very important that you should have a perfect and a sound sleep at night. So for that you should not be stressful, always be happy. And this is just one trick, maybe I don't know it works for you or not, it works for me. Before going to bed, to pray to God that God please help me to rise up early in the morning. And definitely this happens, that you are tight with your eyes, or your sleep gets breakdown at the time of 4:30 and 5. Definitely this happens with me. Now it is my laziness if I leave the bed or not, but your sleep will be breakdown. Just try it and let me know, did this help for you or not. Till my next video, bye bye, take care, and always keep smiling. Bye bye.